हेलो फ्रेंड्स, माय नेम इज रज़ा मसूद। टुडे वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट टॉपिक कंट्रोल अकाउंट इन प्रोजेक्ट मैनेजमेंट। फ्रेंड, टुडेज टॉपिक इज़ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट एंड वेरी इंटरेस्टिंग विद रिस्पेक्ट टू प्रोजेक्ट मैनेजमेंट। इफ़ यू आर स्टूडेंट एंड स्टडिंग प्रोजेक्ट मैनेजमेंट इन यूनिवर्सिटी और यू आर प्लानिंग टू गिव एग्जाम ऑफ BMP, सो दिस इज़ अ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट टॉपिक एंड यू विल सी दिस टॉपिक इन द एग्जाम। एटलीस्ट 3 to 4 क्वेश्चंस विल डेफिनेटली बी देयर इन द एग्जाम इन विच योर कॉन्सेप्ट रिलेटेड टू कंट्रोल अकाउंट विल बी चेक्ड। Secondly, friend, if you are a professional project manager and working in any organization as a project manager or IT software manager, so again your concept should be very clear about this topic so that you can utilize this concept in your professional and implementation life of project management. So friend, let's start. First of all, I would request to please subscribe to my channel and click on the bell option as well so that my new videos can reach to you. So let's start. Control account in project management. Friend, control account, also referred to by abbreviation of CA, is a tool that is utilized as a management control point that involves the integration of a number of specific and key elements of a number of project specific elements, and after the successful integration, a measurement of the performance to date will take place. See, friend, this was only just a definition. Just see the term, friend, control account in project management. First of all, this topic is purely related to project management, so your concept about project should be very clear, because all the things which we are talking about are directly related to project. So first of all, we have to understand that what is a project actually. Friend, project, as per the definition of PMBOK, is a temporary thing which has a beginning and ending point, and it gives you a unique output, product, service or result. So two ingredients are very important in every project. One is temporary and one is unique. Every project is temporary, every project is unique. Temporary means that a project will start on some time and it will finish on some time. It has a ending date. Second, project is unique. Unique means that it always gives you a unique output, product or service. Like, we are implementing it on the first time. For example, if you are building a house, so it's a project. If you are building a flyover, so it's a project. If you are building a if you are implementing a mobile application, so it's a project. If you are implementing an e-commerce solution, so it's a project. If you are introducing a new business process in your company, so it's a project. So if you are aware, if you can understand now the concept of project, project is a temporary thing which has a beginning and ending point and give you a unique output or product or service. So two things always remember are important. One is temporary and second is unique. Now, control account. Control account concept lies, friend, like if you just see the term here, control account, that means something which used for controlling. Okay, something which is used for controlling. For example, friend, we know that the management always senior management always interested to control the things. Now what does it mean by control actually? Friend, control means that the senior management want to control the cost actually, the scope actually, the schedule actually. Okay, so these are the things which management want to control. For example, they want that if the budget of a project, for example, some task must be completed within for example $500, okay, let's assume. So they want to control means that they want to ensure that the cost should not be increased from $500. They want that the that particular task should be completed within 10 days. So they want to control. Control means that the task must have to be completed within 5 days. If they are if the task is taking more than 5 days, so there should be some alerts, some notifications, etc. So we can be notified, senior management can be notified that this task is taking more time, more cost, so that the corrective actions, so that the appropriate action can be taken. Now फ्रेंड मैनेजमेंट कंट्रोल, व्हाट इज़ एक्चुअली कंट्रोल अकाउंट? इज मैनेजमेंट कंट्रोल पॉइंट वेयर स्कोप, कॉस्ट, स्केड्यूल आर इंटीग्रेटेड एंड कंपेयर टू द अर्न वैल्यू फॉर द परफॉर्म. अर्न वैल्यू मीन्स फ्रेंड दैट वट एक्चुअली वी हैव अर्न. अर्न वैल्यू मीन्स द कंसेप्ट ऑफ अर्न वैल्यू. फॉर एग्जाम्पल, वी हैव डिसाइडेड दैट दिस टास्क शुड बी कम्प्लीटेड विद इन विद $500 कॉस्ट, एंड आफ्टर फ्यू डेज यू चेक that you have already spent it $100. However, you have decided as per the plan that within 2 days only $50 should be consumed. So this is the earn value. Earn value concept, basically now right now we can only discuss that earn value means that actual work you have earned, actually the work which has been completed. So the control main concept of control account is the performance measurement. Why we use control account? We want to control the scope, cost and schedule in the work in the project. Actually, control accounts are placed at selected management points in the WBS. WBS is the work breakdown structure. In the WBS we place control account so that we can compare, so that we can control the scope, cost and schedule. And it are basically usually we place it has more than one or more than one work packages. Here friend few terms which we must have to discuss. First project we have already discussed. Another term is work breakdown structure. Work breakdown structure means that we are decomposing the project into smaller pieces so that we can estimate it. This is the work breakdown structure, which is normally called as divide and rule. Divide and rule concept means that if we try to control, if we try to estimate a whole project, it is difficult. However, if we divide the project into 8 to 10 pieces, into a smaller pieces, so that it will become easier for you to manage it. Work package is simply a collection of related tasks in a project, and they are often considered sub projects in one project. Since just simply think that, for example, work package concept, that for example if you are implementing e-commerce solution, now you have to develop, you need to test, and you need to production deployment. So you can say that the development is a work package. Work package means that it has subtasks. Okay, so that is called as the concept of work package. Now friend, just see from here WBS, this is simply an example of WBS. Here you can see 1.1, 1.2, these are the code of accounts, and you can see this is the example of work breakdown structure in which a project is decomposed into sub levels. Here you can see the CPI is 0.8. So this is an example of the control account. Why? Because we have placed the control account here. That means the cost performance index should be 0.8 here. So we are assuming, we have placed the control account here so that we can control the cost here. We can also place at some other level as well. However, the purpose of making the cost here so that we can control the cost here. Also, we can place some schedule factor here, scope factor here as well. So just try to understand the concept of control account here, friend, that management can place the control accounts in the WBS so that they can control the scope, cost and schedule. So that is the main purpose of control account. If you just see the term here, control means that management place the control account in the WBS work breakdown structure so that they can control the scope, cost and schedule. So we can use this concept in WBS work breakdown structure so that we can use it to control the project. So the friend, thank you, thanks a lot for your time, and that's all from my side. I hope you like this video. If you like, please share it with your friends and colleagues, and thanks a lot for your time. Thank you.